非常高兴见到你。
46 years ago, when I visited China for the first time, I told Premier Zhou Enlai that China was a mystery to me. He replied that the 900 million people who were then living in China did not find it mysterious. And once I got to know China, neither in time would I. Since that time, I have had the honor of visiting China countless times, probably over 100 times, learning something new on each trip. If China is less mysterious than before, I have realized that the culture of China is so manifold that I will never cease learning. Since then, 9 American and 5 Chinese administrations have made getting to know each other and understand each other a permanent feature of the international order. And the presidents of both sides of universities represented here have made a great contribution. And of course, Madam Liu has been in a leadership position through much of this period. She has done a great deal personally to educate me on the various aspects of Chinese culture, inviting me to visit various museums in which she acted as a guide. But far beyond that, chairing the people's exchanges between our two countries in the recent past. What started as a strategic move by both China and the United States has evolved into an absolute prerequisite for world order.
今年呢是中美上海公报发表45周年。45年前，中美两国领导人以长远的战略眼光和非凡的政治智慧，开启了中美关系正常化的大门，实现了中美两个大国跨越太平洋的握手。45年来，两国关系虽然也有风雨，但是势不可挡的向前发展，正像基辛格博士所讲到的，九任美国总统，都是主张中美，这个发展这个友好合作的关系的。所以我想，这种关系不仅给两国人民带来实实在在的好处，也为地区和世界的和平、稳定和繁荣做出了重要贡献。中国人常说，前人栽树，后人乘凉。今天中美关系的大树之所以能够枝繁叶茂，我们一定要感谢那些在春寒料峭的时节播撒希望的种子的人们。在此呢，我再一次提议，让我们以热烈的掌声向在座的基辛格博士，向所有的 为中美关系的发展做出贡献的人士表示崇高的敬意。